of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap. And here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubank.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you and welcome to Trivia Trap. The game for those of you who like to know a little bit about everything. Now, Trivia Trap is played by these two opposing teams. Boy, are they ready to play. Somebody today could win a pot of gold worth $10,000. Not bad at all. Over there, our returning champions are juniors. They're all under the age of 30, and their opponents are the seniors. And here on Trivia Trap, we have a rule that when you hit your 30th birthday, you automatically become a senior. And these are the seniors over here. Perry, how are you, sir?
Bob, I'm fine. My name's Perry Mayer, and I'm in the ad business.
Good. Nice to have you with us, Mary.
Hi. My name's Mary Harper, and I'm an accountant.
Wonderful.
And I'm nervous.
Get excited and nervous all you want.
Dang. I am. My name is Betty Glover, and I'm a choreographer, Bob.
Well, there they are, our seniors on Trivia Trap today.
We're proud of us.
Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
If you are a fan of trivia, you've come to the right place. Chance to win $10,000. However, the two ladies over here, they brought their secret weapon again.
Mm-hmm.
Here they are. Hello, juniors, and hi, Alice.
Hi, Bob. I'm Alice Swan. I'm an economics student at UCLA and a waitress.
Good for you. John.
My name is John Pirelli, and I'm still just an office clerk.
Yes, from Jersey City, New Jersey, right? And?
My name is Ann White, and I'm a graduate student at USC.
Nice to have you back. Returning champions are juniors on Trivia Trap. All right, we're ready to play our game. As always, we start with our seniors. Perry, you will make the first choices. Up here on our game board, seniors, I'll show you two rows of answers. The top row consists of these very nice answers. Lover, commander, henpecked, old man. Nothing personal, please. On the bottom row, how about these? Hugh Hefner, Idi Amin, John Lennon, Mick Jagger. Top row or bottom row, Perry?
I think we're going to try the bottom row.
For the bottom row. All right, seniors, good luck to you. Here is your first question now. Who made this controversial remark in 1966? We are more popular than Jesus now. Now, one of those answers up there is the right answer. What you must do as a team is cut the wrong answers one by one, leaving only the right answer. If you do that, cut all three of them, then it's worth $300 to your team. I'll repeat the question. Who made this controversial remark in 1966? We are more popular than Jesus now. Cut a wrong answer, Perry.
I'm going to cut Idi Amin.
Let's find out. For the seniors, eliminate Idi Amin. You're off to a good start. The way to do it. And now, Mary, you must cut a wrong answer.
I'm going to cut John Lennon.
Let's see.
No, I got a reason.
Audience is rather vociferous about this. Well, how about it? Can we eliminate the answer, John Lennon? I knew you were in trouble right away. No?
Right.
Actually, to clarify that, Lennon stated that he meant that the Beatles were not better than Christ, just more popular at that time. That was back in 1966. You did eliminate one wrong answer, though, so we'll give your team $50 to start off with, and we'll pause for these words, and when we come back, we'll have more Trivia Trap, and the juniors will have their first chance to play today.
Pizza flavor.
Welcome back to Trivia Trap. Our seniors started off with $50 in their first question. Remember, it's the team that makes it to $1,000 that wins the game and then goes on to play for a possible $10,000. Juniors are our returning champions, and they're ready to do this right now. Alice, you know how to do it. Up there, lover, commander, henpecked, and old man. On the bottom, these answers. Here they are. Rip Rock Falls, Hollerville, Bug Tussle, Hog's Head. Top row or bottom row?
Oh, gee, top.
The top. Here's your question, juniors. Rudolph Valentino was known for his role as the sheep. What does the word sheep literally mean in Arabic? You must cut the incorrect answer. Three of them are up there. Cut all three. Your team gets $300. Begin, Alice.
I'll cut lover.
Yeah. Eliminate lover for the juniors.
Yeah. Ah.
John, the trivia machine, it's your turn.
I'll cut henpecked.
Okay.
Yeah.
John says we got to cut the answer henpecked. How about it?
Yeah.
Indeed. Oh, Anne is feeling the pressure. Rudolph Valentino was known for his role as the Sheik. What does the word Sheik literally mean in Arabic? And two answers remain. One is wrong. That's the one you need to get $300.
I'm going to eliminate old man.
The audience and everybody says you have done right. I hope you're successful. For $300, cut old man. Isn't that interesting? Sheik in Arabic means old man. Old man. You got two of the three, though. I'll give you $50 for each one. So you have $100. And let's go back over here to our seniors. Mary, your team has $50. Rip, Rock Falls, Hollerville, Bugs Hustle, and Hogshead. Bottom row of answers. On the top, Mary, take a look at these. Prince, Cummins, Luther, and Michael. Top or bottom?
Top.
On the top. Here's your question. One of the biggest rock superstars today is known as Prince. What is his first name? You must find the three wrong answers to get the $300. Mary, begin.
I will eliminate Luther.
Eliminate Luther for our seniors, if you would, please. Ah. It's a good choice. Betty, are you a Prince fan? I knew you were, Betty.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, no,
you've got to cut a wrong answer now, Betty.
A wrong answer. All right. I'm going to eliminate Michael.
Really? I'm not sure about that. Cut the answer, Michael. So far, so good. For seniors, you know a lot about rock stars so far. Well, Perry?
Okay.
I'm sure you're a Prince fan. I know you listen to the records all the time. One answer remains that is wrong. If you can find that answer, your team gets $300 and you'll take a lead.
I'm going to try the answer that doesn't sound like it should be. I'm going to cut Cummins.
For $300 for our seniors, let's eliminate the answer Cummins. Hey, I thought that was a tough category for the seniors. I was worried about them.
Purple Rain.
Purple Rain. You know, his full name. Oh, you have kids?
Sure.
And they're Prince fans.
Sure.
Hmm.
Purple Rain is fucking
up
his
name. Oh, yeah, I know. His full name is Prince Rogers Nelson. Prince Rogers Nelson is his first name. You knew that all the time. Hey, good.
Sure.
You got $350. Let's go right back over to our juniors. John, you make the choices. Rip Rock Falls and the other three answers are on the bottom. On the top, juniors, this group. Father Goose, Charade, Touch of Mink, and Walk, Don't Run. John, what will it be? Top or bottom?
Top.
The top row. What was the last film Cary Grant made before his retirement? The last film Cary Grant made before his retirement. They're talking about Prince as seniors. You're talking about Cary Grant as juniors. This ought to be interesting. Cut the wrong answers, juniors. Begin, John.
I'm going to cut Touch of Mink.
Let's see if we can do it. The juniors wish to cut Touch of Mink. How about that? Good choice. And find the wrong answers. Your team gets $300.
I'd like to cut Charade.
Let's take the answer Charade off our board, please. You're safe. One answer remains, Alice, between you and $300. And if you get it right, that means your team will take a lead by $50. That'll be important to you in our trivia race. So this is an important answer. What was the last film Cary Grant made before his retirement? Find the last wrong answer.
Let's cut Walk, Don't Run.
For $300, a chance to begin the trivia race. Cut Walk, Don't Run. That was it. That was it right there. Walk, Don't Run was his last one. You got two right, $50 for each one. Give you another $100. You now have $200, juniors. Seniors have $350. That is the end of round one. In a moment, we'll be playing our $1,000 trivia race. No one ever got to that list of answers, though. Kind of fun. Rip Rock Falls, Hollerville, Bug Tussle, Hogshead. Why don't we play with our audience at home? I'll ask you a trivia question. Let's see how well you do with this one. Before the Beverly Hillbillies moved to Beverly Hills, they came from a small town in the Ozarks. What town was it? You know? Think about it. I'll tell you the answer when we come back, and we'll also start our trivia race.
You snooze? You lose.
You know the actor, Beverly Hillbillies? Well, they came from a little town in the Ozarks called Bud Tussle. Bud Tussle. That was the correct answer. I hope you got it at home. Okay, let's go back to our game, because we're going to have a really good trivia race right now. Juniors have $200. Seniors out in front with $350. Naturally, what they have to do is reach the goal of $1,000. How are we going to do that? Easy. We're going to play our $1,000 trivia race. Here we go. Now, we're going to play our $1,000 trivia race. First team to get the $1,000 then goes on and plays for $10,000. Seniors are out in front. They get to start first. In the trivia race, every question is worth $100. Then after the 10th question, the values will then double. Each team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three members miss, then control goes over to the other team. As I said before, seniors are in front with $350, so they start. Cherry pick a category, royalty, comic strip, or Oscars.
Royalty, please.
The race has begun. For $100, you have $350. Trying to get to $1,000. Here's your question. What's the maiden name of England's Princess Diana? Time's up, Mary.
Rainier. No.
Incorrect. Betty.
No.
Spencer was the correct answer. You're frozen at $350. Control goes to the juniors. Alice, the category.
Oscars, please.
For $100, you have $200. Trying to get to $1,000 in 1977, just after the death of this actor, he was awarded an Oscar. Who was he?
Peter Finch.
You're right. Peter Finch. Right. $300. John, what category will it be? John, are you excited?
Yes.
I could tell you were.
Doctors.
Doctors. For $100. Name the doctor who delivered the Dion quintuplets. And?
Dr. Jones.
Incorrect, Alice.
Ed Tailhill.
No. Dr. Defoe was the correct answer. You're frozen at $300. Like seniors have $350. Trying to get to $1,000. Perry, pick a category.
Archie.
Archie for $100. Who played Archie Bunker's partner, Murray, on Archie Bunker's Place? Mary.
I wish he'd known me. I don't.
Betty.
Oh, God, please.
Time's up. Martin Balsam. Now Perry knows. You're frozen at $350. Control back to you, John. Here we go.
Movies
for $100. Who played the sadistic Sergeant Fatso Judson in From Here to Eternity?
Ernest Borgnine.
Correct answer. Now you've got $400. Trying to get to $1,000, and you pick the category.
Comic strip, please.
Comic strip. For $100, juniors, what's Little Abner's last name? Time's up, Alice.
I don't know.
John. Don't know? Yoakum. Yoakum. Mammy Yoakum. I thought you'd get that. You're frozen at $400. Perry. Control goes to the seniors, $350, trying to get to $1,000. Pick a category.
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio for $100. Seniors, in the story of Pinocchio, what kind of animal did bad little boys become?
Wolf.
No. Mary?
Donkey.
It's a donkey, right? Betty, you have control of the categories.
Oh, and I'm going to try breakfast.
Breakfast for $100, seniors. What cereal is advertised as the breakfast of champions?
Wheaties.
Wheaties is right. Perry's trying to get to $1,000. Here we go, Perry. Killers. Killers for $100, seniors. What famous entertainer was shot by Mark David Chapman?
John Lennon.
John Lennon. Did he make it in time? He did not.
John Lennon.
John Lennon's a correct answer. $650. Betty, the category.
50's TV.
50's TV. You're trying to get to $1,000. You have $650. Who was Perry Mason's district attorney's rival?
Hamilton Burger.
You're right. Hamilton Burger. Very good. All right. That was our 10th question. Hereafter, all questions are worth $200. You have $750. Trying to get to $1,000. Perry, which will it be?
Early TV.
Early TV for $200. Who was the first host of The Tonight Show?
Dave Garraway.
Incorrect. Mary.
Perry Como.
Incorrect. Betty.
Steve Allen.
Steve Allen, you're right. Rescued your team. $950. One answer away from winning the game and a chance to play for $10,000. Perry?
Casablanca.
For the game and a chance to play for $10,000 in the classic film Casablanca. What performer sang As Time Goes By?
Dooley Wilson.
You're right. Dooley Wilson is the correct answer. Dooley Wilson. In 100 years, I would not have known Dooley Wilson. Juniors, didn't happen for you. you today. You won a little over $2,400 as a team. Thank you very much for being with us. We'll see you again. John, you keep smiling now, all right? Oh, Julie Wilson. They'll be back. Our seniors are our champions. Congratulations to you. To play for $10,000. It'll be fun. We'll see you in a minute.
Picture and see what it's really like to become an army of one.
Welcome back to Trivia Trap. You know what? You did it as a team. You were just wonderful. Everybody contributed there, and you did a marvelous job. And how in the world, Perry, did you know about Dooley Wilson? Casablanca is my favorite movie. I've seen it 24 times.
Well, it paid off.
Believe me. Are you ready to play for the big money? Okay. Now we're going to play for our $10,000 pot of gold. As we get ready to climb our trivia ladder. You ready? Seniors, go over there and get in position. And good luck to you. Now, seniors, up until now, you played as partners, but now you are on your own. Now, each of you will be trying to win money for yourself. Your positions have been determined by your success in the trivia race. Betty, you're in the number one position. That means that you'll have the option to play or pass on the first group of answers. The top of our ladder, $10,000. If you're ready to begin, good luck, Betty, Mary, and Perry. I hope you all win. Let's go to the first level. Answers: Teddy Roosevelt, Herbert Hoover, Warren G. Harding, Franklin Roosevelt. Betty, you have the option. You can play, or you can pass them on to Mary.
Bob, I am going to pass them on to Mary.
Not too thrilled about those, all right? Mary, you're in there.
And I'm
nice
going to pass
too.
Them on to Perry.
You're going to pass them on to Perry. Perry?
I'm going to try.
Yes, you have no choice. These are yours now. You must
find
the correct answer. If you do, you win $1,000, and you earn the right to play for $10,000. Perry, here's your question. Who was the first president to broadcast a speech on radio? First president to broadcast a speech on radio for $1,000. Chance to play for 10 big ones. Perry, I need the correct answer, please.
I'm going to try Herbert Hoover.
Good luck. I hope
Thank you
there for you. Was Herbert Hoover the first president to make a speech on radio?
No.
It was Warren G. Harding. Harding was the president. You'll be back tomorrow to
I
play. All right,
Thank
we'll
you
see you tomorrow, Perry. We'll join your team members tomorrow. Now, Betty and Mary, we're going to go right to our next level of our ladder, so take a big, deep breath, and here we go. And another group of names. This time, Pat Nixon, Mother Teresa, Joan Collins, and Bo Derek. Betty, again, you're in that position where you can play or you can pass them on to Mary.
I'm going to play.
You're going to play?
Yeah.
All right. This is for $1,000. A chance to play for $10,000. Here's the question. Who was born with the name Mary Kathleen Collins? For $1,000, I need the correct answer. Who was born with the name Mary Kathleen Collins?
I am going to say Mother Teresa.
Mother Teresa. Audience. They don't know. Let's see. How about it? For $10,000, or a chance to play for $10,000, was Mother Teresa born with the name Mary Kathleen Collins?
Oh.
No. Bo Derek. It was Bo Derek.
Bo Derek.
Betty, we say goodbye to you. We'll see you tomorrow when you join your team.
I can't visualize her as a Mary Kathleen.
Something about calling Bo Derek Mary.
Mary
I just don't know.
Yes.
Hi, Mary.
Hi.
How are you? Are you ready? Good luck to you. I want you to do this. Are you ready? Let's go right up to the next level then for Mary. Now we're going to get serious. Captain Kangaroo, Mr. Rogers, Soupy Sales, Mr. Wizard. You have children?
Yeah, eight years old.
Oh,
I don't have
any. Here's your question. What is the name used on TV by children's show host Don Herbert.
Don
Herbert. I need the correct answer for
$1,000. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Mr. Rogers.
Mr. Rogers.
It's a guest.
She would love to play for the $10,000. It's worth $1,000 to her. How about it? Is Mr. Rogers' real name Don Herbert? Don Herbert is Mr. Wizard.
Mr. Wizard.
What do your kids watch?
She watches the news.
Oh, good.
You know.
I'm sorry that I didn't have Mike Wallace up here
for
you.
There you go.
Yes.
We got it right.
Hey, you
but
don't get to play
closer.
For... Yes,
I
you
so
did.
I closer than I came before I came here.
Yes.
Isn't it?
That's
right
a trivia through? Question in itself.
Who's on first?
We're going to pause for these words, and we'll be right back to reunite our seniors, and we'll all cry together in just a moment.
Jones Squares, followed by Match Game.
To Bob Eubanks and the seniors.
All right, thank you, Jim. They're fun. They didn't win any money, but boy, are they fun. I'll tell you that. Okay, as a team, you did real well. You are our champions, and that means you'll return as our champions. You didn't get any of that $10,000 today, but if you play as well tomorrow as you play today, or on Monday, then you're going to really be there. So the very best of luck to you. Perry, Mary, and Betty, our seniors, will be back. And before we go, I thought it'd be fun just to leave you with a little bit of trivia you might be able to use over the weekend. Take this one to a party. In Goodwater, Alabama, they celebrate annually with a casket race. 6 people carry the casket. 1 rides inside holding a glass of water. The winning team receives a handmade miniature coffin with a blue ribbon. The reason for all of this? Goodwater is the coffin-making center of America. Bet you didn't know that. See you tomorrow. Trivia chat. Bye-bye. See you next time.
Okay, everybody, today's science lesson is all about our solar system, including
water
Earth.
Water is essential to all life on Earth, and water... Kyle, you'll be tested on this.
To our next problem, 2 trains leave the station at the same time, both heading west if one is south.
Okay, Kyle, for a chance at $50,000, 2 trains leave the station at the same time, both heading west. If the first train is...
You should have paid attention in school. Get schooled. Win tuition every night at 8:30 on Game Show Network.
Uncle Ben's original Long Grain and Wild Rice.